Welcome to the last session of this fourth International Congress on Research and Innovation in Neurodegenerative Diseases. I am Maria Pastor, neurologist working at the University of Navarra. I will be chairing this session. And the topics that we will address today are dopaminergic degeneration, Parkinson's disease therapeutic targets, nanomedicine, and CSF biomarkers. I would like to introduce you the first speaker of this morning, Professor José Luis Lavandeira. Works at the Center of Research in Molecular Medicine and Chronic Diseases at CIMUS at the University of Santiago de Compostela, and is head of the Department of Morphological Sciences at the University of Santiago. Ready to hear you.
Thank you for the introduction, and thanks to the organizers for the opportunity to speak here today about brain renin-angiotensin system and dopaminergic degeneration. The renin-angiotensin system was originally considered as a circulating hormonal system to control blood pressure. The precursor protein, angiotensinogen, is transformed by renin and angiotensin-converting enzyme into angiotensin II, which is the most important peptide of the system. Angiotensin II acts on two major receptors, angiotensin type 1, 82, and angiotensin type 2, 82. More recently, local renin-angiotensin systems were found in a number of peripheral tissues and in the brain. And these locally produced angiotensins play a major role in the pathogenesis of degenerative diseases of these tissues by two major mechanisms. First, angiotensin is a major activator of via 81 receptors, is a major activator of the N-ADPH oxidase complex, NOX, which is the second major source of superoxide and oxidative stress in cells after mitochondria. And second, angiotensin is a key mediator of inflammation in these tissues, in part by activating NOX. A second interesting point for this brief introduction is that in cells, particularly vascular and renal cells, in which both systems are present, angiotensin and dopamine receptors interact, counter-regulate each other to control important cell functions. And alteration in these interactions, dysregulation in these interactions, particularly observed in aged animals, led to degenerative changes in these tissues and degenerative diseases. And what about the CNS? The brain has a local independent renin-angiotensin system separated by the blood-brain barrier, and all components of the system were located in the brain. Angiotensinogen and angiotensin is produced by astrocytes, particularly by astrocytes, and at very low levels by neurons and microglial cells. This brain system was initially investigated and related to areas controlling blood pressure, and then more recently, it was associated with other functions. And what about, more specifically, what about dopamine-angiotensin interaction in the nigrostriatal system and a possible role in dopaminergic degeneration? As I told you before, oxidative stress and inflammation are the two major mechanisms for the deleterious effects of angiotensin in peripheral tissues, and oxidative stress and inflammation, neuroinflammation, are also two major mechanisms for progression of dopaminergic degeneration and Parkinson's disease, independent of a number of factors that may trigger, initiate the degenerative process. Therefore, in the nigra, dopamine and angiotensin may also interact, and deregulation in this interaction may lead to oxidative stress and inflammation and progression of dopaminergic degeneration as previously observed in peripheral cells. To clarify this point, we investigated three questions. First, whether there is a local renin angiotensin system in the nigra and striatum. Second, if there is a functional dopamine angiotensin interaction. And third, if a dysregulation in this interaction may contribute to progression of dopaminergic degeneration, may contribute to dopaminergic vulnerability. Regarding the first question, we found all components of the system, including different NOX units, in colocalizing with dopaminergic cells, with astrocytes, and with microglial cells, particularly activated microglial cells, initially in cultures, primary cultures of the nigral region, but also in vivo in the nigra of rodents and primates. In this case, in the case of primates and humans, in collaboration with the group of José Luis Lanciego. Here we can see dopaminergic neurons in a monkey substantia nigra expressing angiotensinogen 81-82 progranulin receptors. We corroborated this expression using different methods, including laser microdissection of isolated cells in the nigra and PCR analysis of different components of the system. The second question was whether there is a functional interaction between both systems in the nigra, in the nigrostriatal system. And we observed that a decrease in dopamine using different methods induce an increase and upregulation of expression of 81 receptors in the striatum and in the nigra, and also a compensatory upregulation of 82 receptors which was not observed in H animals. We think that angiotensin is modulating, regulating dopamine, the dopaminergic system in the basal ganglia, and including the motor effects of dopamine and also the immunomodulatory effects of dopamine. We corroborated this interaction between both systems, between both types of receptors, using different knockout mice and mice overexpression different angiotensin and dopamine receptors, in the case of dopamine receptors in collaboration with the group of Rosario Moratalla. And we observed that at least some of these interactions maybe are by forming heteromers between receptors of both systems, as we could observe recently in striatal neurons in collaboration with the group of Rafael Franco. The third question was if a deregulation in these interactions may contribute to progression of the degenerative process. And we use different in vitro and in vivo models of degeneration of Parkinson's disease to investigate this question. In a number of studies, we observed that in the nigra, angiotensin 2 acts on 81 receptors and induce an important increase in N-ADPH oxidase activity in NOx and an increase in levels of superoxide and oxidative stress in dopaminergic neurons, leading to an increase in vulnerability of these neurons against very low doses of dopaminergic neurotoxins and other factors. This process can be blocked, inhibited at different levels of the pathway. However, we found particularly interesting the use of angiotensin receptor 81 antagonists, angiotensin receptor blockers, sartans, because these drugs are currently used in clinical practice against hypertension. And some of them, such as candesartan and telmisartan, are very effective at crossing the blood-brain barrier. We also investigated the level of activity of the system, of the ROES system, in the nigra and striatum, in models in situations of high level of dopaminergic vulnerability, such as age animals and different models of menopause. And we observe an important increase in ROES activity in the nigra and striatum, increase in the expression of 81 receptors, decrease in the expression of 82, together with an increase in markers of oxidative stress and inflammation. All these markers were decreased by treatment with 81 antagonists, such as candesartan, which also supported the major role of this system in dopaminergic vulnerability. This increase in levels of superoxide induced by angiotensin was also observed in primary cultures. Here we can see an increase in levels of superoxide in dopaminergic neurons using red fluorescence with ethidium. However, this increase in levels of superoxide in the dopaminergic neurons may be due to a direct effect of angiotensin on 81 receptor located on neurons, but also maybe an indirect effect of angiotensin on glial cells, particularly microglial cells, as they also have angiotensin receptors. Here we can see that, that in neuroglial primary cultures, there was an increase in levels of superoxide in microglial cells, as we can see here. We corroborated this major role of the microglial cells on the effects of angiotensin on dopaminergic neurons using cultures lacking glial cells, or specifically lacking microglial cells. In these cultures, major effects of angiotensin on dopaminergic neurons disappear or almost disappear. In microglial cells, angiotensin acts on 81 receptors and increase N-ADPH NOx activity in microglial cells and upregulates, increase the microglial neuroinflammatory response and major components of the response. Interestingly, this was inhibited by treatment with 81 antagonists, such as candesartan. This is a possible model of effects of ROES hyperactivity on dopaminergic neuron vulnerability and the microglial neuroinflammatory response. A number of pathogenic factors may affect the dopaminergic neurons and induce a decrease in levels of dopamine. And we have found that a decrease in levels of dopamine induce an increase and upregulation of 81 receptors in dopaminergic neurons in microglial cells, as well as an increase in the production of angiotensinogen and angiotensin in astrocytes. the increase in the activity, the 81 NOx activity in dopaminergic neurons, increased levels of superoxide, and perhaps more importantly, the increase in the activity of the 81 NADPH NOx axis in microglial cells increase the inflammatory response and the release of superoxide and inflammatory cytokines, which affect dopaminergic neurons and increase levels of oxidative stress and vulnerability of these neurons. We also found that independent of the levels of changes in levels of dopamine, pro-inflammatory signals such as LPS may upregulate the expression of 81 receptors and the 81 NOx activity in microglial cells, and also neurotoxins such as MPTP, MPP+, may act directly on astrocytes and increase production of angiotensinogen and angiotensin, for example, in cultures of pure cultures of astrocytes. In summary, there is a classic renin angiotensin system, a circulating system, which controls blood pressure. A second level is the local tissue or paracrine system, in which in the brain angiotensinogen is produced mostly by astrocytes, angiotensinogen and angiotensin, which acts on membrane receptors located on neurons and glial cells, as we have I have just described in the nigrostriatal system. However, recent data suggest a third level of renin-angiotensin system, at least in some types of cells, the intracellular or intracrine system. We have observed an intracellular system in dopaminergic neurons. With confocal microscopy, we observed that major components of the system were located in the nucleus or clearly in the cytoplasm. In cultures, or also in vivo, as we can see here, in dopaminergic neurons of a monkey for a progranulin receptor, and located in the nucleus or surrounding the nucleus. In mitochondria, we observe using confocal microscopy and immunohistochemistry, electron microscopy, or transfections of fluorescent receptors, treatment with fluorescent angiotensin, which colocalize with markers of mitochondria, the presence of angiotensin receptors, different angiotensin receptors in mitochondria. Using cell fractionation methods, we also observe that in the mitochondrial fraction, we could observe 81 and 82 receptors. 82 are much more abundant than 81 receptors in mitochondria, and this ratio changes in mitochondria from aged animals. Respirometry studies indicate that these angiotensin receptors modulate mitochondrial respiration, as we could see with different agonists and antagonists and knockout mice. We also observe different components of the system in isolated nuclei. In this case, for example, 81 receptors. 81 receptors were more abundant than 82 receptors, and we are investigating the effects of these components on levels of nuclear superoxide and in the expression of different cell components. Finally, I'd like to thank all members of the research group for and all collaborators for their contribution to the results that I presented here. And thank you all for your attention.
Who is ready for the first short question? Jesus.
Well, although I arrived a little late, and I'm sorry for that, but in the last slides, I found one that in microglia, there is an increase in the signaling effect through ROCK1. There is an increase in this kinase, ROCK1, at the end. And then I wonder if you have tested anything about cytoskeleton, because ROCK1 is a cytoskeletal protein or can modify cytoskeletal protein, modifying the morphology of microglia from one shape to another shape. The question is, have you tried to look if changing morphology could be due to the presence or the activation of ROCK1?
It's a very interesting question, and in fact we have already studied that question, and we have some specific papers focused on the effects on ROCK and ROCK kinase. And angiotensin and the activation of NOX in microglia increase expression of ROCK kinase, and I think that is a main factor responsible for that component that I showed in the slide about increasing the migratory and the migratory response and the phagocytosis by microglia. I think that is mediated by this increase in ROCK kinase, which is the activity of ROCK kinase is increased by AT1 receptors via an ATPH oxidase complex. We have a specific paper in glia, published in glia about that question. Yeah.
Very, very interesting, José Luis here. So I think if I understood correctly, you have analyzed in the dopaminergic neurons, you have found increased in the levels of NOX4, of the NADPH4 isoform, right?
No. I think that the membrane receptors, the paracrine or extracellular pathway increase activity in NOX2.
Okay, but because in mitochondria, that's what I would have expected, but I saw the plot
that
with NOX4. Okay.
The slide from mitochondrial results. In mitochondria, we observe that 81 receptors activate NOX4 and increase level of superoxide in mitochondria. And 82 acts via NOS and increased levels of nitric oxide.
Thanks.
Hi. Thanks for your talk. I'm also interested in mitochondria. Could you further explain this? You just mentioned that 81 and 82 receptors modulate the mitochondrial respiration. Could you further explain these things?
I'll try. I am not the expert in mitochondria in the group, but what I can tell you is that 81 receptors increase levels of superoxide and increase respiration, mitochondrial respiration, and 82 decrease mitochondrial respiration. And we confirm that with agonist and antagonist, and also with mice knockout for 81 and 82 receptors. So I think that we think that this intracellular system is a very is an important system to counter-regulate oxidative stress, particularly oxidative stress induced by the extracellular system. An intracellular system was observed or was suggested in some vascular cells, and it is not known the function of this system, but it was suggested that this system may be an intracellular system to increase the effects of the extracellular system. In fact, some the most recent antihypertensive drugs, the renin inhibitors, aliskiren, it was claimed that they will be would be more effective because they could inhibit both extracellular, paracrine, and intracellular system. And we think that this is not correct. And the intracellular system, in normal conditions, has more abundant 82 receptors. And this is a mechanism of protection against angiotensin and against oxidative stress. And I think that is not interesting to block the intracellular system.
And thank you, Professor Lavandeira. I think the question remaining, probably the speaker will take them in the break. And thank you.